Hi guys, my name is Roger and in this video I'm going to play with the internal synthesizer of the Roland MV8000. A long time ago, Roland launched an update and they added an analog modeling base. Well, in other words, a virtual analog synthesizer. The same one like they added to the SP808, which is a very beautiful synthesizer. The only down part is that the bass synthesizer is monophonic, so you can only play one note at a time. But the advantage of the MV8000 is that it's a sampler. It's a sampler, so you can sample that sound and then you can spread that sound over the keyboard. Also, because they say it's a virtual analog synthesizer, you should be able to create some drum sounds, because the TR-808 is, for example, an analog drum computer. So I put some time in it and I'm going to show you some results. Curious? Here we go!
The virtual analog synthesizer of the Roland MV8000 is an effect. So we have to select over here effect, and then you will see the effect, multi effects, delay and chorus, and it's about this one. So if I go to the library, we see here some analog bass, and I can use this. And as you can see here, I've put it on aux 1, I will put it on input, and I will create here a MIDI track. In the output assign, I put on MFX. Okay, cool. So it's now on MFX. I will adjust the name immediately. So, delete. And let's say MFX. Okay. So this is the MFX. We check it to be sure. Yes, output assign MFX. So if I play now on my keyboard, you will hear the sound of the analog bass synthesizer. It's this sound. Okay. And as you can hear, it's mono. But okay. We go to MFX. And we go to the library, because, well, I created some sounds. Let me go here. We go to 15. So I will do a preview. And this is the hi-hat I created with the analog modeling bass. I created also a hi-hat open, a snare, a bass drum, some toms, a clap, cowbell, another clap, a cymbal. So those are the sounds I've created. I will show you how it looks like. For example, this bass drum. I say use this, okay. And I'm going to edit it. And I will check the mixer because the sound is very, 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 very soft. Now it's better, okay. Okay, we go to effects, edit. So this is the bass drum I've created, and as you can see, I've created here I adjusted here the parameters of the cutoff and the resonance, because when I take down the resonance, sound will disappear of the bass drum. And if I go to 100, there it is. And if I adjust the envelope, the decay, you have the pew 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 pew. on 30, and I created this bass drum sound. Okay, so far so good. What I did then is I went to sampling and I sampled all the sounds, all my created modeling bass sounds. I sampled and I created my own drum kit. If I go to instruments here, patch edit, analog drum. Over here, I put all my drum sounds. So I will show it here on my keyboard. Well, you will hear it. On my keyboard, I have these sounds. Those are samples of the analog modeling bass. So if you put them together in a beat, you get something like this. All these sounds are created with the analog modeling bass. So in my opinion, very cool. What I did then, I created also some bass sounds. So I go to edit. Wait, first I have to select. I go to library and I also created some synths, some bass synths, something like this. Note. Preview. Wait, I have to put this one, of course, here. Exit, exit. I have to be here. Okay. Effects. Library. Preview. A synthesizer. And more. So I've created those sounds, I sample them, and when you sample something, you can make it a keyboard. So let me show it in instruments. I sampled it, and now I can play on my keyboard as a sample. The electric piano. Now it's a polyphonic sound. Some other sounds. These are all sampled analog modeling bass sounds. And for example, this one, I added some portamento with time of 15. Also what I did is change the attack offset and the release offset so it has now more release, and you get, well, in my opinion, a very nice synthesizer sound. Done with the modeling bass of this one, of the MV8000. Over here the same. This was also very nice, because if you add an LFO to a sound, you get this this effect. Okay, if you sample this one, that LFO will not be in sync with, for example, your sequencer. Because the lower the note, the lower the tempo of the LFO. But it gives very nice effects. And also what I did, if I go to partial edit, sample edit, I searched for the right loop. Let me go to this loop point. If we zoom in, I took over there the yellow part. I said, okay, this is my looping point, and my end point is here. So before it ends, before it starts here, I said, okay, end it here. My looping point begins where it should end. So if you listen now to this sound, it's looped. It's perfectly looped. Very cool. Okay, so all together, I created something like this. Well, it's not just a bass. You can also create your own drum sounds because, boah, crazy, crazy, really crazy. Okay, guys, thank you for watching, and we see each other next time. Bye-bye.